Charlie Wheeler has a dairy farm in the south of England. He is one of the best judges of cattle in the district. And today, his neighbour has brought a young bull round to be valued before he takes it into market. Mr. Laxton is a piano tuner in London. Looking after 250 pianos takes him into all sorts of homes, and in all of them he has friends who look forward to his visits. Miss Nicol is a typist. Business is brisk today, and so is the dictation. But that doesn't worry her. She's well able to tackle it. But in one way, she is different from the other typists in the office. She uses a special machine for shorthand. For Miss Nicol, like Charlie Wheeler the farmer, and Mr. Laxton the piano tuner, is blind. The blind people of Britain hold a position unparalleled throughout the world. Every single one of them has the opportunity to have a job of his own, marry and bring up a family, and in every way lead a normal, independent life. England has only 21 blind children under 1 year old, less than 2,000 under 16 years old. These remarkable figures are due to the care taken with newborn babies. Every child that is born must have its eyes examined, must have them treated against the eye diseases that attack children at birth. The sight of thousands has been saved in this way. But there will always be some blind children. In England, rich or poor, they are given special care. In schools of their own, blind children have to learn the simple things which come naturally to ordinary children. Getting dressed and washed are little trouble to most of us, but it is quite another matter when you can't see what you are doing. With the blind, four senses have to do the work of five. They have to get to know things by touch, or sound, or smell. Grow to feel at home in the world around them, and then learn to master it. They learn to count, to use simple tools, and above all, to read and write in Braille. Braille is the blind person's bridge to the world of everyday life and culture. These six raised dots are its basis, and from them any language, any scientific formula, and even the score of a symphony can be read by the fingers of the blind. The National Institute for the Blind has the biggest Braille printing works in the world. Thousands of volumes are printed and added to its library every year. And if a blind student wants a textbook, he has only to ask, and it is specially transcribed for him. With this store of knowledge to draw upon, The children go to their own senior schools, where they follow the same course as sighted pupils. Special apparatus for mathematics and for writing in Braille. They study for the professions and even, as these two girls are planning to do, pass on to the university. All young blind people are trained for independent jobs. Great care is taken to find work that suits their particular abilities and interests. Their enhanced sense of touch makes them particularly good at certain jobs. Massage, for example. Blind students have their own massage school. The principal and many of the teachers are themselves blind. Here, too, they learn to give electrical treatment on specially designed instruments, with controls marked in Braille. The girls often become shorthand typists. They soon learn where the different keys are and use ordinary typewriters. For shorthand, they have a special machine which can do any work with its six characters. Blind girls can work quite as quickly as ordinary typists. For people of a more manual turn, there are many different trades. Piano tuning, with its need for a keen ear and a delicate sense of touch, is a great favorite with them. Of England's 800 piano tuners, 600 are blind. A difficult problem is the care of people who lose their sight later on in life. They have to learn to live in a strange, dark world. No easy matter after the age of 40 or 50. Most of them want to go on working and retain their independence. Home teachers visit them regularly and teach them a new trade, such as carpentry, boot repairing, or in this case, basket making. Work or not, they qualify for a pension at the age of 40. And there's always plenty for them to do. Those whose touch has been too coarsened by hard work to feel Braille can still enjoy reading. Whole books are recorded on gramophone records, which are called talking books, and can be borrowed free of charge. Blind people, old and young, there is the wireless. They do not have to pay for a license, and sets are supplied free to all those who cannot afford to buy one. The Radio Times, a magazine of wireless programs, is printed each week in Braille. With a wireless set at his elbow, a blind man can see the whole world. In England, blind men and women lead a normal life. They can take an active part in the running of their country and in every way be full and free citizens.
And wisdom at one entrance quite shut out, so much the rather thou celestial light shine inward and the mind through all her powers be radiant. There are plant eyes, all mist from thence purge and disperse, that I may see and tell of things invisible to mortal sight.
Thank you.